My name is John Haessle. I was born in France. I came to New York in 1967. When I was 18 years old, I got very sick. I spent a few months in the hospital. And a brother of mine gave me a book on French impressionists, and it changed my life. I loved it immediately. There was only about half a dozen reproductions in it. You know, I walk over, I feel I'm dancing around. I feel happy I'm in it, I'm in the painting. Using oil is still my first love and always will be, but it's slower and it has problems in terms of my health. By living and working a lifetime in the same place, turpentine is not good for your lungs and so forth. So I unfortunately have to limit myself into small painting. I want to experience again to do work which is much bigger, which has a whole different way of throwing yourself into it. Under art, the product itself, which meant in way harder to do because you don't have guidelines. You can do anything you want, which means you know, everything is done. Today, I keep on talking about this because today a young artist can be a sculptor or a painter on, you know, doing videos and doing digital art. Everything is permitted. When I came to this country 50 years ago, artists were more or less put into minimal artists, or you were figurative artists and so forth. Today you do anything you want, which is great, but it has its drawbacks because it's very hard to differentiate with the gimmicks which are going to be used today and which are going to be passé tomorrow. So obviously my inspiration is the past. My love of impressionism was always there. To work from the heart. What you feel, what you want to do. To be inspired is to be alive, to be in spirit. And so inspiration is again a word which now has no meaning, but it's a big meaning because if you're inspired, you're in the spirit of doing the work you want to do and you want to live. This painting is actually the most recent painting. I just did this a couple of months ago. It's very different than the one I just mentioned before. This is a collage paper on canvas. On the subject, especially once get closer, one looks at it, it's fragmentation of a body. Why? Because I used already this kind of work. It's called Body Speaks. It's part of an alphabet. It's now fragmented, but the alphabet was done with two people like this. One person formatting the alphabet. H is two people standing with somebody putting up a leg, so it's an H. This painting is unusual for me to have done because most often my work has to do with color. On this one, beside tiny fence of green and maybe a little yellow, it's all in gray and black. Actually, I call it gray variation. To me, I tried to duplicate. I did another format, the same size. It just didn't happen. This one is unique because it just all fell perfectly apart. I cannot change one little drip or anything. It just happened, and it's like magic sometimes. Unfortunately, it doesn't happen too often, but That's why I intended to be in here. It was done about 10 years ago, and it's acrylic on canvas. This painting is very recent. I just did this about 2 months ago. On contrary to the one before, which is about a little same size, I would think, this one is all about color and about depth, about a kind of a space, a kind of an enclosed space, but still a space. And that's obtained by overlapping different strokes, different sizes and strokes. It looks very kind of free, but basically it takes a long time, and you have to think about what you're doing in the same time, while not being constricted into, you know, I want. Forget about I want. You just let flow. That's important.